Hello, I am Kiki Willis.
And I'm Fabrice Mohannigan.
In today's news, a local young Riverside girl stole my parking spot, and I have her license plate number here with me now. I'd like to share it with you. Look who's waiting now.
I like big meat in my mouth. That's what they're saying at Big Bulge Burgers, a new burger establishment that opened in West Hollywood. I gotta tell you, Kiki, I went there myself, and they're not kidding. This meat, I could hardly fit it all in my mouth. It's a huge and delicious, girthy mouthful.
So beat.
Oh, I know. I got wasted last night. Oh.
I can't get this coffee in me fast enough.
Good morning, guys.
Jesus, you're perky.
Well, I've changed my coffee intake.
What do you mean?
You know how when you stick drugs up your butt, you get higher, faster, harder?
Yeah.
Well, Folgers has taken the coffee out of the mug. How? I'll tell you how. By a 21st century scientific breakthrough, Folgers has found a way to capture that warm, brown, delicious premium blend and concentrate it into a gel capsule for easy anal insertion. Now, you take that coffee, stick it right up your ass, and you are ready to start your day!
Wow, that sounds so easy.
Oh, it is.
I don't know about you two, but I'm about to take a trip to the little boys' room and start my day the Folgers way.
Looks like you're not the only one.
The best part of waking up is Folgers in your blood.
Let's do this.
No, 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 no!
Ain't no sunshine when she's gone.
You and me, we used to be together.
But if you see me walking by, and the tears are in my eyes, wave, baby, look away.
Do you jog here a lot? I like your shoes.
How's your run?
Fine. Fine. Great. I'm good. Amicable. You know, it had to be done. It was hard, but it was inevitable, and it's gonna make me better for it. Let's go to a strip club.
What?
There's an exit on the east side of the structure. When I count to three, you run like hell, got it?
But if someone is there?
Well, you have to trust me. I have got you this far, haven't I?
Whatever you say.
Okay. One, two, three.
Whoa.
What the hell are you waiting for?
What the hell?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, did you just...
Quit? Yeah, she just totally quiffed.
That is hilarious. Oh, jeez.
No, I did not just quiff her.
Yeah, you did. You just totally quiffed.
That is the funniest thing ever.
I got you now, Lefton. You thought you could evade me? All these years I've been after you, but I got you now, you bitch.
What the hell is so funny?
Dude.
She queefed.
Like a real fucking queef?
Straight from the Valley of Dawn!
News, our British correspondent, Veronica Fairweather, is live in our UK newsroom. Today, a young British girl who suffered severe brain damage has been rewarded with £5 million. I have known a lot of brain damaged men. They were strong, firm, hard, men. However, their brain was in their dick, and thankfully they were rewarded with nothing. So good for you, girl. And that's the story here today in London. Once again, I'm Veronica Fairweather, reporting to you live. Back to you, America. Thank you for that, Veronica. Now, back to the real, real news here in America. The land of the free and the home of the brave.
thank you for that, Veronica, for keeping us abreast of the news abroad. Wow, what a tantalizing story that was. Real news there.
I love your teeth.
I'll be right back.
I want to brush them.
Long bathroom lines got you down? Well, not anymore. Now you can get your party on and not miss a beat. With Trash'ems Party Girl Adult Diaper Panties. Using science, Trash'ems let you keep drinking and not thinking. About the potty, that is. They come in three stylish prints. Leopard, Tiger, and Hello Kitty. A comfortable, stylish adult diaper for the party girl on the go.
I never go anywhere without my Trash'ems anymore.
Literally. Trash 'em at the beach. Trash 'em at the mall. Trash 'em at the nail salon.
I trash 'em too.
And for that special man of the night, try Trashum's Party Guy Adult Diaper Briefs.
Because it's not that we can't hold it. It's that we don't want to.
Trashum's.
Mom, hey, Dad.
Hey.
Welcome home, son. Take a seat. Your mother was just finishing up the dinner table.
Meatloaf, your favorite.
Thanks, Mom.
Tell us about your first semester at Dartmouth.
Really great, actually. Really love my teachers and I'm making lots of new friends.
Oh, that's good to hear, son. That's good to hear. I'll tell you, college is where you find out who you really are.
Yeah, that's kind of why I wanted to talk to you guys.
Oh, yeah?
What is it, honey?
Mom. Dad. I'm gay.
Denise, these potatoes are divine.
Thank you, honey. Mm.
Did you guys hear what I said? I'm gay.
That's nice, dear. So, have you picked a major yet?
I don't think you hear what I'm saying.
Oh, we hear you, Chief. Loud and clear.
And you guys are okay with it?
Okay with what, honey?
That I'm gay. A homosexual, a fruit.
Sure. Oh, jinx, you owe me a Coke.
Good one, honey. Will you pass the peas?
Fuck the peas. You know what? You see this? What I'm wearing? I don't like to wear this. I like to wear this. Yeah. Because I am
I should get one of those for my Pilates class.
Are you still taking those classes?
Oh, well, I started back last week.
I like penis in my mouth, big ones.
Well, it's a good thing you've got your mother's lips.
Oh, Henry, you're such a card.
What the fuck? I am gay. Gay.
All right.
Last night I was in the bathhouse getting it from behind by a guy named Enrique. He was wearing nipple clamps and a cock ring. I came five times, Mom. I had to have ice on my ass all morning.
We should go there together to get a man and Patty on Parents Weekend.
What? No, what? What's wrong with you people?
We cool, son. We cool. You know? I mean, I know this may be hard to believe, but we were in college once and we were wild.
Oh, Henry.
Come on, Denise. It's true. A couple of animals we were.
I give up. You guys say you're cool with me, then I guess you're cool with me. That I'm gay.
No biggie, son.
No biggie.
Okay. I guess it's good then. I'm gay.
Now eat your meatloaf, Peyton. It's got him cold.
You know what, Mom? I don't really like your meatloaf either. Get out. What?
Get out! Drink water.
Oh.
And drink water.
Water. Water.
Maybe some water.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Here's that file, Sam.
Oh, thanks, Daly. Hey, you got a second, bud?
What up?
Well, you're good with the ladies. And, I've been having a little trouble with the missus.
Shoot.
All right. But you gotta keep this on the DL, all right?
So down low.
I can't make my wife come. I can't get her to come.
Hold up one second. Sorry. Go ahead.
Anyways, so we've been married like a little less than a year. And, you know, I get it. Like, women don't always come. I get that. But, you know, sometimes they do.
So your wife has never come?
No. Are you texting Kyle over there what I'm telling you?
What? Come on, man. I told you it was on the DL.
All right. I guess it was just a coincidence.
So your wife has never come. Continue.
Yeah. So, you know, I've tried everything.
Everything?
Yeah, different positions.
What else?
The Kama Sutra.
Mm-hmm.
I tried that. I tried. We tried watching porn. We made porn. We made it. And, you know, she had me lick her butthole, all right? And then she licked my butthole. And then she put her finger in there.
Where?
Where do you think? You know, I've done everything. I watched an instructional video on Cunnilingus. I did role playing. I was a prince. And I was a pauper. I sucked a little baby carrot out of her asshole. I sucked it. And then we used peanut butter. Peanut butter. I am allergic to peanuts daily. My lips swelled up like a banana slug. A couple of them. All right? They swelled up! We used a strap-on.
Strap-on?
I was the catcher.
Oh my god!
Who are you texting?
Hey. It's personal, dude. Don't worry, Sam. I got you. So when was the last time that you made a girl come?
I never have.
You son of a bitch! I said to keep this on the DL!
Hey! You're freaking out, dude.
No, you're freaking out. You're freaking out, just like the time you freaked out all over the boss's ass in the copy room at the Christmas party. Yeah, that's right, everybody! Daily fucked the boss in the copy room at the Christmas party. Why don't you text that, cool guy?
Not cool, man.
You're not cool.
That was hurtful. Of course, everybody knew about that. Right, boss?
Good time, Daily.
But it still hurts. You want to see my phone? You want to know who I've been texting?
Yeah.
I was texting my grandma. She's in the hospital.
I'm sorry, the dinging.
Whatever, man.
What's a banana slug?
Today's episode is brought to you by the letter X.
Hey, y'all. You know who it is, and you know what time it is. Okay, but first, I have to interrupt your regular programming to talk to y'all about the letter X. Hey, yo, Q, man. Yo, turn that shit down, dog. Hey, yo, man, you know I'm doing my internet show. Somebody gotta pay the bills around here. Where was I? Oh yes, the letter X. X. I like to start with a little ecstasy. Cause my nerves is bad. All the stress around here. And besides, it makes me feel exuberant. Oh yeah, helps me to exude my sexuality. And when I be up in the club, y'all have no choice but to get excited. Because I got all this experience. Okay? I like that one. Yeah. Experience. Ooh, yeah. That's when I'm feeling extra good. Who do I run into but my ex-boyfriend? You know, he never could afford me because I am expensive, okay? But I don't let that bother me though, because I come to dance, so I just keep on dancing. Oh, it's my jam right here. Ooh. Yes, I can hear all the instruments. I can hear the El Zena! Hey, what's that instrument called? You know the one that starts with the letter X?
Xylophone.
Yeah! Oh, girl, you crazy. No, that starts with the letter Z. We can talk about the letter Z maybe next week, okay? I think that about does it for this week's episode of Rashawn's Rump
see y'all next time. It's time for me to make my exit.
This just in, a bomb has gone off at a local mall in Glendale. Our correspondent Brittany Walsh is live there now, aka Sista, on the scene. Britt, can you tell us what kind of devastation we're looking at?
Hey, what's up, LA? This is your Sista on the scene. Child, they are blowing up malls in Glendale. I'm here with,
Laverne Miller.
Miss Lillian Dillard, who was a witness to this tragic event. Lucy, tell us what happened.
It's Laverne. I was walking into formal fashions, and I heard this loud noise.
Wait a minute. Did you say formal fashion? Girl, that is my store. I got this blouse there. Ain't it cute?
Anyway, there was this loud bang, and then people started screaming.
Do they have any sales today?
Excuse me?
Lucy, sales on shoes, girlfriend.
I barely had time to think with the bomb and all.
Woohoo! Did you hear that, y'all? Formal Fashion is having a sale on slingbacks. You better get your tail down here real quick to get a steal on these explosive savings. This is your Sista on the scene. Back at you, Kiki.
Thank you, Brittany, for setting us back another 10 years.
And that's all the time we have for today. We'll be back at 6 o'clock with more top stories and more top news, like one from our correspondent Jed Billard, who is sticking it to the man. The man at the sticker trade show, that is.
I love stickers.
Me too, Kiki. Me too. Well, that's today's news.
Today.
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 Today. Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Today.
Konnichiwa.
Today.
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 Tomorrow.
Today.
This evening.